Good morning everyone. In this video I am going to explain about cell site antennas and mobile antennas. The various objectives of this lesson are: upon completion of this topic you will be able to know about cell site antennas and mobile antennas. Recap: in the last class we studied the other type of antennas like DTH antennas, such as parabolic dish, which is most widely used for satellite communication. Satellite communication is a technology of data transmission, whether one-way data broadcasting or two-way interactive using frequency as a medium. We can make use of microwave frequencies. For uplink, we have 6 gigahertz, and for downlink, we have 4 gigahertz for Ku band, the C band transmission, and we have other bands also, Ku band and Ka bands. And this satellite communication system consists of a space segment, it is also called as satellite. Then there are a number of satellites that are used for various applications. The Intelsat, that is for international satellite communication. INSAT for Indian satellite communication. The Intelsats are owned by a group of countries, and INSATs are owned by India. So different countries launch their satellites for different applications. In that, the microwave antennas are used for satellite communication. And for a satellite communication, we require ground segment, and which is also known as the earth station, which includes antenna, outdoor unit, interfacility link, indoor unit, and customer premises equipment. So all these topics we discussed in the last class in detail, and we also studied about VSAT. VSAT is a satellite based communication service that offers a flexible and reliable communication services, so including enterprise wide networking with high reliability and a wide reach that extend even to remote sites. VSAT network provides reliability in transmission of data, that is data, voice, video. It is the most important network for data transmission, voice transmission, video transmission. Data means internet communication, computer communication. Voice means long distance telephone communication, including landline and mobile communication. Video means the broadcasting of television channels or some media channels. So VSAT network providing high reliability in transmission of data even to remote places. Allocation of resources to different users, bandwidth, amplification, power. So this VSAT provides certain bandwidth to the users depending upon the requirement. It is providing certain power amplification to the user. So allocation of the resources that can be done with the help of the VSAT network. We have discussed all these things in detail in our previous video. Or a Cassie grain feed, or a Aggie feed, or Foley dipole feed, as we have discussed in feed mechanisms of the parabolic reflector antenna. So for DTH and DTH systems, we make use of the horn feed. For the large size of VSAT systems, we can make use of a Cassie grain feed for conveniently locating these antennas on the ground. This is a parabolic reflector antenna, large size antenna looking toward the satellite, and here this is the primary feed. This shape is the parabolic reflector shape, and this is the primary feed antenna. The signals are received through it, the waves are coming from the satellite. They are striking the surface of this mesh structured parabola, reflected by the parabola structure and made available at this particular point. Similarly, when it is used as a transmitting antenna, it is connected through the waveguide. This primary feed is connected to the waveguide, to the transmitter radiating the signal. It comes up to the primary feed horn antenna radiate the signal. They strike the body of the parabola and reflected, and they are going toward the satellite. So parabolic dish antenna, the main antenna for the purpose of microwave applications. In VSAT and DTH, the parabola dish antenna is most widely used antenna. And the radiation pattern is unidirectional. So we have a main lobe, and these are the minor lobes. It is a directional antenna, and maximum gain divided by root 2, if we take, we are getting the 3 dB points, and then we are getting the 3 dB bandwidth. So we have a beam width here. The 3 dB beam width is the angular separation between half power point, then half power beam width, then beam width between the first tunnels. These are the first tunnels. Then we have the beam width between the first tunnels. The maximum radiation is in the direction of the forward wave. So we have a forward transmission. It is a directional antenna where earth station is looking toward the satellite, or earth station receiver is looking the satellite for the purpose of reception of the signals. Applications of the parabolic reflector, as we have seen, are used in television, used in data communication applications, used in radar applications, satellite communication applications. So television means transmitting the signal through television transmitter, through ground station, data communication for internet applications, radar, radio detection and ranging for gathering the information about the distant objects. So we can use these radar systems at the aeroplane maintenance, that is aerodromes. And we have satellite communication system for communicating the various earth station through the satellite. And we have microwave links. So these microwave links, point-to-point microwave links that are making use of applications of the parabola reflector. And cellular base stations also having the parabolic reflector antenna from one base station to another base station. They are communicating with each other by means of the parabolic reflector antennas. So this is the main antenna for microwave applications. DTA system, VSAT system, television broadcasting, data communication applications, radar communication applications, satellite communication, microwave links, cellular base stations. In all these applications, we can make use of parabola dish antenna. Rather, we can say wherever microwave transmission is there for point to point, for directional properties, we can make use of parabola dish antenna or antennas with parabolic reflectors. In VSAT systems, so this is the main antenna. Very small aperture antenna. This is serviced in land areas which are difficult to install. Remote locations, water areas, where it is difficult to install the system, the VSATs are providing the communication facilities. It is ability to have direct access to the users and users' premises. So these VSATs are having direct access to the users. And that can be provided, facilities can be provided up to the user's premises. And very small aperture terminal antenna. For VSAT, we require very small aperture terminal antenna, mostly the dish antenna. With horn feed is used in many of the applications. Fixed network solutions at reasonable price. It provides point to multipoint, that is broadcast. Point is a satellite, it is a broadcasting to different receivers, for example, DTS system used by many users, multipoint users. So it is a point to multipoint, that is a broadcast. Multipoint to point, it is data collection from many points to one particular point. It is the special application for data collection. And point to point communications, broadband, multimedia services. So broadband means that the bandwidth is more, and we have many multimedia, text, audio, video, and animation, etc., many services. Typical VSAT system, it consists of outdoor unit, and it also consists of indoor unit, and there is a link provided between outdoor and indoor units. So outdoor unit consists of antenna, then feed horn. This antenna, mostly the parabolic reflector antenna, it is looking toward the satellite. It is oriented azimuth wise, elevation wise toward the satellite so that it can pick up the signal. And here horn antenna is placed, the signals coming from the satellite, they will be striking the parabola shape and reflected by this parabola. The reflected waves will be coming toward the focus point. Parabola has a focus point, and the energy is available at the focus point. We can collect that energy through horn antenna. Horn antenna converts that electromagnetic waves into electrical signal, and then this electrical signal is transmitted through the interfacility link. It may be a coaxial cable, or it can be a waveguide for microwave applications. Through a cable, it is connected to indoor unit. We have data port, voice port, and then it is applied to the receiving equipment. So up converters and high power amplifiers used for converting and amplifying the signal before transmitting to the feeder. So we have up converters for VSATs for transmission purpose towards satellite. Satellite is very far away. It is about 36,000 kilometers from the ground, and hence we require high power amplifications so that that signal power can go up to the satellite. That is used for converting and amplifying the signal before transmitting to the feeder. So up conversion, placing the modulated different channels onto an uplink frequency, and then high power amplifiers are used to amplify the signal for the purpose of for transmission, and that signal is applied to a feed horn of the parabolic dish antenna. So extended C band, we have down converters for reception. This is while receiving, we have a down converter. Means the down converted frequency is 4 gigahertz for the case of C band that is received. The signal is at 4.5 to 4.8 gigahertz, and the up converter converts it to 6.725 to 7.025 gigahertz. This is the uplink frequency band is 6.725 to 7.025 gigahertz. That is the uplink from transmitting earth station to the satellite. And this is the downlink from satellite to the receiving earth station. Downlink is from 4.5 to 4.8 gigahertz for the case of extended C band transmission. Nowadays we have Ku band 14 gigahertz uplink and 12 gigahertz downlink. Ka band 30 gigahertz uplink and 20 gigahertz downlink can be used for the various applications. As the frequency increases, the size of the dish antenna decreases, and we can have more direct to gain for a VSAT antenna. And mostly time division multiple access techniques are used. Multiple accessing means many multiple users can access a common communication medium. Here common communication medium is the satellite. Through satellite, many users are accessing the satellite. That is by means of multiple access techniques. There are different multiple access techniques, such as frequency division multiple access technique, time division multiple access technique, and we have latest code division multiple access techniques. In frequency division multiple access technique, the frequency slots are used so that they can be transmitted through a common communication medium. Whereas in time division multiple access, based on time sharing, the transmission is done. One station is allocated a particular time slot, the next station is allocated the next time slot, and so on. And we have number of time slots for number of stations. Through the respective time slots, different stations are accessing the common communication medium. We have the users connected to VSAT hub, and then there is an uplink and a downlink because of the bi-directional transmission. For outgoing channel, the uplink is available 512 kbps in this particular example. The return channels 128 kbps return channels coming to the VSAT hub. Through VSAT, the users are connected. And similarly, the direct users, the distant VSATs can also have access. So 512 kbps outgoing channels from the satellite, then to 128 kbps return channels that are accessing the toward the satellite. So the purpose of the satellite is to receive the signals from the VSATs and then amplify the received signal, down convert it to downlink frequency, and then retransmission to the distant end. So in the form of time division multiple access, these signals can be accessed through a common communication medium. The VSAT hub communicates with all the VSATs. Typically, VSAT has a parabolic dish antenna, 1.8 meter diameter. And this is the basic VSAT system where the network uses different computer terminals are connected in the form of various network, such as in local area network, different users are connected to LAN. In wide area network, different users are connected to wide area network, and then all those are connected to a terrestrial network. Through terrestrial network, it is connected to a earth station. So all the terrestrial channels, all the different users in the form of multiplexing coming to a earth station, and then this earth station communicating the satellite. Through satellite, it is broadcasted. Processing is done in the satellite and then retransmitted toward the receiving earth station, and we have the satellite hubs, and then we have the internet backbone network. Through that, different terminals are connected, and there is a global communication possible with the help of the satellites, and then with the help of the VSATs, and remote users can also be connected. And we also studied DTS system. I'm just recapitulating here. It is also one of the most important system where the television users can directly receive the signal, television programs from the satellite. At the transmitting end, we have the head end equipment, TV transmitters. Through head end equipment, they are connected to the uplink antenna. Uplink antenna is a four dish antenna, microwave dish of very large size, and then these signals are radiated toward the satellite. Satellite process the signal and then retransmit it to the desired direction. And this is a part of the DTS system where we have a receiving antenna, dish antenna. Small size is enough because nowadays the transmission is done through Ka band, that is a 30 by 20 gigahertz band is used. That is the reason DTS systems will have the lower diameter for dish antennas. So we can receive the antenna. We can receive the signal through this receiving antenna. And through setup box, it is connected to the user's television sets. So many multiple users, they can receive through the satellite. Satellite is broadcasting the signal. Many multiple users can receive the television program that is broadcasted by the satellite. So So direct to home system, it is a television system, it is a method of receiving satellite television by means of signals transmitted from direct broadcast satellites. So they are the signals that are received from TV transmitting stations through the satellite. And this is the in detail diagram of the DTS system. We have a broadcasting center for a particular TV station, and all the different TV stations are coming toward the earth station. They are multiplexed in this, and then through the form of TDMA, they are accessing the satellite, and then satellite processing it and retransmitting towards the distant end. The transmission is done in the Ku band for the purpose of DTS system. The main advantage of going for Ku band, that is 30 by 20 gigahertz, is the receiving antenna size is decreased. We can make use of small size antennas for the television users. That is the reason with low cost, we are able to receive the television signals broadcasted through DTH satellites. And we have DTH antenna, that is a dish antenna. Then low noise balance is used to for impedance balancing of this cable. And then through this coaxial cable or waveguide, it is connected to a setup box. The function of the setup box is the received signal is in the microwave frequency, downlink frequency. So TV receiver cannot respond for that gigahertz signal. So this setup box converting that frequency, that microwave frequency into a megahertz frequency suitable for demodulating through the television receiver. The picture is demodulated, the sound is demodulated, picture goes to the picture tube or monitor, and the sound goes to the loudspeaker. In this way, we can able to reproduce the television signal through the television receivers. So for the purpose of DTH, we have a dish antenna, satellite dish is used. The signals are coming from the satellite and they will be reflected by the dish antenna. And then we can pick up the signal here. The horn antenna is placed through the waveguide or coaxial cable. It is connected to the television receivers. Now we will discuss about the cell site antennas with this background. And this is the most important antenna used for cellular systems. Cellular systems are for mobile communication. Cellular system consists of base stations. Base stations are the interconnection switching centers. And it also consists of mobile units. The users are carrying the mobile. So one of the modern communication is the wireless telephony of mobile telephone. The users are provided with mobility. Whereas in case of landline communication, the users are connected to a fixed landline. The users can make use of that particular location only to make the calls, to receive the calls. Whereas in mobile, there is a mobility provided to the users. Wherever you go, you can carry the mobile telephone, and which is having an antenna, and that is communicating with the base station through the cell site antennas. A refined version of the mobile telephony covering most regions of the earth is a cellular telephony. Cellular covers areas are divided into smaller areas assumed in hexagonal shape. These hexagonal areas ranging from 0.5 kilometers to 20 kilometers, they are called cells. The total geographical area is divided into number of hexagonal cells. So as shown in the figure, the communication area are divided into hexagonal cells. Suppose this is a particular area. This particular area is divided into hexagonal cells, each having the radius varying from 0.5 kilometers to 20 kilometers. If the density is more, the cell size is less. If the number of users are less, the cell size is more. So in that way, we can provide the geographical cellulars. So the total area is divided into hexagonal cells. The purpose of dividing the region into hexagonal cells. We are not making use of square cells or circular cells because they cover only small area. So hexagonal cells covers a large area. That is the reason the total area is divided into number of hexagonal cells for the purpose of providing communication facilities by installing base stations at each cell. At the center of the cell, there is a base station. It is nothing but a communication equipment, that is a switching equipment. The mobile users are connected to that particular base station. As long as the mobile users are within this particular area, this base station is providing connections to the mobile stations, mobile users. So when a mobile user crosses this boundary, then this base station is looking after the call processing functions. As long as the users are within this particular geographical area, then this base station is looking after the call processing functions. Likewise, when the user moves to this particular area, then this base station, like that, the total geographical area, we have the hexagonal cells. At the center of each and every hexagonal cell, we have the base stations, and these base stations are interconnected to provide master control. So all these base stations are connected to your master station. Each base station is responsible for covering that particular region or cell. The cells are hexagonal with the base stations at the center. The base stations are interconnected using a common control system called a master station controller. Master station controller is an MSC. A base station must be capable of transmitting and receiving calls simultaneously. Normally, the same antenna is used for transmitting as well as receiving, but nowadays the cost of the antennas are less, so we can make use of different antennas for transmission as well as reception. Mobiles can communicate with each other through the base stations. If the base station is connected to the public switched telephone network, PSTN, for example, if this is the base station, if there is a nearby telephone exchange or a public switched telephone network, PSTN, if it is connected to base station, then the mobile users can able to communicate with the landline users. Similarly, the landline users can able to communicate the mobile users. So this is the structure of the cellular area. So the total area is divided into hexagonal cells depending upon the density, the type of equipment, power level transmission, the hexagonal cells ranging from 0.5 kilometers to 20 kilometers area. Then at the center of each and every cell, there is a base station. At the base station, we have a cell site antenna. These cell site antennas are located at the base stations. These antennas are used as base stations to transmit and receive calls to and from mobile units. The purpose of the cell site antenna is to transmit and receive calls to and from mobile units. The antennas used for cellular radio systems must be omnidirectional. The reason is the signal should be available to this particular area, total OD, omnidirectional pattern. Omnidirectional means the signal should be radiated in all the directions equally. Then only, as long as the mobile users are there in that particular area, they can able to pick up the signal. They can able to communicate with the base station through the cell site antennas. So typical antennas used at cell sites are either collinear antennas for omnidirectional or log periodic antennas for directional properties. If it is from one point to other point, then we can use log periodic antennas. Whereas collinear antenna arrays are used for omnidirectional radiation patterns. And these are the cells. At the center of the cells, we have the base stations. Each cell has a base station. that controls all the handheld cell phone within the coverage area of that particular cell. Each cell base station has a tower on which both transmitter and receiver antennas are placed for operations and control. And we have these antennas, base station antennas. We have the equipment near the tower. Through the cable, it is connected to the antenna system. So each cell has a base station that controls all the handheld cell phones within the coverage area of that particular cell. And then each cell has a base station as a tower on which both transmitter and receiving antennas are placed for operation and control. These are the cell site antennas located on the top of the towers of the base stations. Base station, sometimes we also call it a cell site. That is the reason the antennas used at base station are cell site antennas. This is another orientation of the cell site antenna, looking toward the other base station, and the omnidirectional radiation pattern we can provide by collinear arrays, thereby that particular geographical hexagonal cell is covered. Here's another structure. For omnidirectional pattern, we can make use of collinear antennas. For directional radiation pattern, we can make use of collinear antenna arrays backed by reflector, or we can make use of log periodic antennas. Omnidirectional pattern is a pattern where we can transmit the signal, we can have the radiation characteristics, radiation of EM waves in all the directions of that particular geographical area. We can make use of collinear antennas. For directional pattern means from one point to other, for example, from one base station to other. So we can make use of collinear antennas, but it is a reflectors are placed behind so that it is directed only toward the other point, receiving point. So depending upon the requirement, we can make use of omnidirectional radiation pattern or directional radiation pattern. We can also make use of log periodic antennas for directional radiation properties. And we have examples of different cellular antennas. We can make use of half-wave dipole, or we can make use of full wave monopole above ground plane. Above ground plane, this is the ground plane, and we have lambda by 4 below the ground plane. The mirror antenna is there, lambda by 4. The total length of the antenna becoming lambda by 2. And this can be used as a cellular antenna. And we can place dipole in corner reflector. This is a corner reflector. We can place a dipole so that the signal will be transmitted only in that particular direction. The reflector is reflecting the signal, so that the signal cannot penetrate in this direction, so it is only forwarded toward the directional properties. Base station antenna, it use antenna with higher gain. It could be a omnidirectional antenna or sectorial depending upon cell type. OD antenna is not possible, then we can transmit the signal in the form of sectorial. For example, one sector 120 degrees, another sector, sectorial antenna, another 120 degrees, the remaining 120 degrees, another sectorial antenna is used. So we can make use of three sectorial antennas oriented for every 120 degrees, thereby covering the entire 360 degrees omnidirectional radiation pattern. We can make use of collinear arrays. It is a collinear array is nothing but a lambda by 2 dipole, and a lambda by 2 dipole, they are fed. Then it is providing omnidirectional radiation pattern like this. We have a main lobe, there are side lobes, and then when we combine all these, we are getting a pattern similar to the omnidirectional radiation pattern. And we can make use of log periodic antenna for directional properties. This is having very wide bandwidth with constant standing wave ratio. Typical gain is 10 dBi. It is a log period antenna. The reason is that we have a wire kept like this, another wire. It is molded like this. The dipole antennas are provided here. We have number of dipole antennas. They are fed in this direction. Thereby, the signal is propagated in the forward direction toward the receiving antenna. For directional properties, we require log periodic dipole array antenna. So, directional radiation pattern can be achieved with the help of the log periodic antenna arrays. The directional radiation pattern is like this. Only in this direction, the maximum energy is radiated. When the signal is fed from this line, so we can get maximum energy propagated in the forward direction. And we can also make use of AGI antennas. We have discussed AGI antenna in detail in our previous video. We have a reflector, driven element, director, and parasitic elements. So the element that is directly connected to the feed is the driven element. Reflector reflect the signal, and then we can get a main lobe. It is a directional antenna. We can transmit the signal in this particular direction, or we can receive the signal from this particular direction. And we have the main lobe, and because this reflector is not reflecting all this energy, there will be some back lobes also. We have to minimize it. And we have a directional base station antenna. This is a base station antenna. So this AGI antenna is placed connected here on the top of the tower through the coaxial cable or waveguide. It is connected to a transceiver. So the signal is radiated only in this particular direction. So we have a directional radiation pattern like this. And there is no radiation pattern in this direction. So the signal can be propagated only towards this particular area. Omnidirectional antennas, collinear vertical antennas, the family of omnidirectional antennas, wireless antennas, number of elements are required. If the number of elements are more, we can get more directivity. Depending upon the frequency, the physical size of the antennas, gain, directive gain, how much directive gain we require, depending upon that, we can make use of number of elements. Beam width, how much bandwidth is required between first tunnels, how much bandwidth is required between two half power points, based on that, we can design the structure of the antenna. Models with many elements have very narrow band beam widths, require stable mounting and careful alignment of the antennas are required. Be sure nulls do not fall into important coverage areas. So if it is falling in the important coverage areas, there will be an interference with other stations. Rod and grid reflectors are sometimes added for increasing the directivity. Omnidirectional antennas with collinear vertical arrays are placed here. It's a collinear line is linear here, and we have antennas placed in the stalk like this, and we will be getting the radiation pattern. If the number of element is 1, power gain 1, number of element is 2, power gain is 2, and so on. If you go on increasing the number of elements, the power gain increases. That is the reason we can have vertical arrays connected in the form of a collinear, and how much directivity we require, based on that we can place the number of collinear vertical antenna array elements. Sector antenna reflectors and vertical reflect antennas. Vertical combinations of dipoles we can make use of. We can use AGI antennas or log periodic antennas. With the reflector can also be placed to avoid the transmission in the unwanted direction. Vertical plane pattern is determined by number of vertically separated elements, varies from 1 to 8, affecting mainly gain and vertical plane beam width. Horizontal plane pattern is determined by number of horizontally spaced elements, shape of the reflectors, and we have sectorial antenna array reflectors and vertical antennas. Number of vertical antennas are located here. For one vertical plane, we have this direction, this vertical plane pattern. If you observe in the horizontal plane pattern, it is covering one third of the region. If you place one or more antenna, this region is covered. If you place another antenna in this region is covered. Thereby, we can provide omnidirectional radiation pattern with three sectorial antennas positioned by 120 degrees apart. If you want more antennas, then the sectorial angle we can minimize it. So cell site antennas are used at the base stations to provide communication with the mobile users. Now mobile portable antennas are for the users. The users carrying the mobile unit, that is a cell phone. At the mobile, we have a cell phone antenna or a mobile antenna. Mobile and portable antennas are used with cellular and PCS systems, should have omnidirectional radiation pattern, and also should be small in size, especially in case of portable phones. The most suitable antenna for mobile units is the quarter wave monopole. These antennas are also supplied with portable phones. For mobile phones, the most common configuration consists of quarter wave antenna with a half wave antenna mounted collinear above it. These two are connected by a coil which matches the impedance. So we can make use of quarter wave antenna. We will discuss now. The handheld portable cell phone is an important electronic gadget to all the sections of the people nowadays for instant communication. The users are carrying their mobile units, portable units, and there is an antenna for communicating with the base station antennas. This is the handheld mobile units. This is an antenna. Antenna, vertical antenna, quarter wave antenna. Antenna is mounted very small as the frequency of transmission is more. The antenna size is decreasing. Even the antenna is placed as a microstrip antenna on the PCB itself. As the technology goes on increasing and the users are provided with the latest communication facilities, they can make use of a very small size antenna, miniaturized antennas. And we have PCS antenna systems, personal communication system antenna. It is a small vertical antenna. It is a coil of a quarter wave. Depending upon the wavelength and frequency, the antenna size varies. This mobile and portable antenna used with cellular and PCS systems. The pattern to be omnidirectional and small. The reason is omnidirectional means wherever the mobile user goes in that particular cell area, geographical area, then that antenna must communicate with the base station antenna. The simplest suitable antenna is the quarter wave dipole. The use of the quarter wave dipole because when it is mixed with the ground plane, then in the length becomes lambda by 2. So the quarter wave length is lambda by 4. So the size of the antenna is small. Usually supplied with portable phones. There is a mobile antenna, quarter wave dipole, or a quarter wave monopole. Mobile and portable antennas. We have the TV and mobile transmitter and receiver. This is a small antenna. For mobile phones, where compact size is not quite as important, quarter wave antennas with half wave antenna mounted collinearly can be used. They are connected by such that the impedance should be matched. This is a collinear mobile antenna. You have a feeder line. is a lambda by 2 section through coil. It is connected to the transceiver equipment in the mobile. The size is important for mobile phone, so it consists of low profile multi-layered circuit board mounted on the base. It is protectively covered with a light transmission hood fitted around the base. The low profit multi-layered circuit board is provided on the reverse side with a printed antenna and at the front side with a half wave voltage doubling circuit and a light emitting element. These are the mobile portable antennas that are there on the printed circuit boards. These are the mobile portable antennas structure. This is the antenna structure. So in this lesson now we have discussed about a review of DTS systems, cell site antennas. These antennas are used at base stations to transmit and receive calls to and from mobile units. The antennas used for cellular radio systems must be omnidirectional. Narrow beamwidths are also desired. Typical antennas used at cell sites are either collinear antennas for omnidirectional or log periodic antennas for directional properties. For omnidirectional, for radiation in all the directions, we can make use of collinear arrays or sectorial antennas. For directional radiation pattern, we can make use of log periodic antennas. And we also discussed about the mobile antenna. The mobile and portable antennas used with the cellular and PCS systems should have omnidirectional radiation pattern and also should be small in size, especially in case of portable phones. The most suitable antenna for mobile units is the quarter wave monopole. These antennas are also supplied with portable phones. For mobile phones, the most common configuration consists of quarter wave antenna with a half wave antenna mounted collinearly about it. These two are connected by a coil which matches the impedance as we have seen. So in this lesson we have in detail discussion is carried out about cell site antennas and mobile antennas. Frequently asked questions: explain about DTH antenna. What are the applications of DTH antenna? Explain about cell site antennas. Explain about mobile antennas.